So what is cryptocurrency? In today's video, we are going to understand cryptocurrency. Welcome back to Thought Control. A cryptocurrency simply is a decentralized form of digital currency secured by encryptions and algorithms at both ends. What we mean by decentralized is that there is no central authority like banks or the government to regulate this type of currency. This decentralization and the method of encrypting transactions make it nearly impossible to counterfeit or manipulate cryptocurrencies. As we know, many companies issue their own currencies which can then be used to trade specifically the goods and services that company provides. For example, Ola Money, Zomato Wallet, or even Casino Chips. The difference between these token currencies and cryptocurrencies is precisely what we talked about earlier: decentralization and secure transactions. In fact, the crypto in cryptocurrency refers to the cryptographic techniques and encryption algorithm that it uses. Along with that, to manage and record transactions, most cryptocurrencies use technology called blockchain, which keeps an online ledger of all the transactions that have ever been conducted and spreads them out across various computers. Bitcoin was the first blockchain-based cryptocurrency and still remains the most valuable and popular. Let's look at this record-keeping technology behind Bitcoin. Blockchain is basically a specific type of database. What is database? It's a collection of information stored electronically on a computer system. Typically, information or database are structured in a table format to allow easier search and filter options, kind of like a spreadsheet, but bigger, faster, and accessible by any number of users at once. So how does a blockchain differ from a database? Well, all blockchains are databases, but not all databases are blockchains. The key difference lies in the way the data is structured. A blockchain collects information together in groups that are known as blocks. These blocks have a certain storage capacity and, when full, are chained onto the previously filled block, forming a chain of blocks containing data, hence the name blockchain. Any new information is now added to a fresh block, which will again be added to the chain once filled. Each block is given an exact timestamp as to when it is added to the chain. This system results in an irreversible timeline of data if implemented in a decentralized way. And in Bitcoin's case, as we know, blockchain's ledgers are spread across various computers, so no single person or group has control. Instead, all users store data collectively. So each computer or a group of computers is operated by separate individuals or groups in a different geographical locations. These computers that make up Bitcoin's network are called nodes. And in blockchain, each node has a full record of the data stored on the blockchains since its inception. In the case of Bitcoin, the entire history of Bitcoin transactions. So if one node has an error in its data, it can use the thousands of other nodes as a reference point to correct itself. This way, no one node within the network can alter data, again making the history of transaction in each blockchain irreversible. It makes the system transparent. Let's say you want to hack and alter the blockchain to steal bitcoins. If you just change your copy, it would just be rejected by the other nodes as illegitimate. To actually pull off a feat like that, you will have to control and change at least 50% of all the nodes at the same time. An attack so huge will cost more than it can steal, making it practically fruitless. This technology that makes it impossible to forge transactions is central to the appeal of Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies. The key thing to understand here is that Bitcoin merely uses blockchain as a means to transparently and securely record payments, but blockchain can be used to record any kind of data points. The only goal of blockchain is to allow digital information to be recorded and distributed but not edited. And it does not always need to be decentralized. Private or centralized blockchain can certainly exist. Many experts see blockchain technology as having serious potential for uses like crowdfunding. In fact, a vast number of blockchains projects are underway currently. For example, using the blockchain technology to count votes in a democratic election, which can result in a drastic decrease in fraud votings. Even information like legal contracts, state identification, a company's product inventory, and much more can benefit from these use of blockchain. But the semi-anonymous nature of cryptocurrency transactions also make them well suited for a host of illegal activities. And of course, some cryptocurrencies are more private than others. Bitcoin, for instance, is a relatively poor choice for conducting illegal businesses online, since the forensic analysis of Bitcoin blockchain has helped authorities to arrest and prosecute criminals in the past. Coins like Dash, Monero, or Gcash are far more difficult to track. A week into the year 2021, the market value of all the world's cryptocurrencies surpassed $1 trillion. Currently, there are more than 6,700 cryptocurrencies being traded publicly. The appeal of cryptocurrencies in the market is for a variety of reasons. Many see them as a currency of the future, so are the racing by them before they become more valuable. Some like the fact that they remove the central bank out of the picture. As we discussed, many supporters like the technology behind them, but most people just like them because they are currently going up in value. Cryptocurrencies may go up in value, but most serious investors still see them as a mere speculation, not real investments. But why? Well, because just like real currencies, cryptocurrencies generate no cash flow. So for you to profit, someone has to pay more than you did. For the same amount of currency, the legendary investor Warren Buffett compared Bitcoin to paper checks. It is a very effective way of transmitting money, and you can do it anonymously and all that. A check is a way of transmitting money too. Are checks worth a whole lot of money just because they can transmit money? And for the people who see cryptocurrencies as the currency of the future, they should note that a currency needs much higher stability than what the current cryptocurrencies have shown. For example, Bitcoin traded at close to $20,000 in December 2017. Its value then dropped to as low as about $3,200 a year later. By December 2020, it was trading at record levels again. This price instability creates a negative cash flow economy. If Bitcoins might be worth more in the future, but why circulate them now? And anyway, which government or central bank is going to give up its authority on regulating national currencies? What are you doing on Valentine?
I don't have any girlfriend.
So, would you like to with me? Would you like to come with me?
Why not? Why not?
Okay then.